Tokyo Electric Power Company may join forces with other electricity and gas utilities to get natural gas resources. The goal is to curb the higher costs in operating thermal power plants. TEPCO estimates that its fuel costs will rise by more than $10 billion in the current fiscal year through March. The increase stems from the suspension of its nuclear power plants following the accident at its Fukushima Daiichi plant. TEPCO is now considering a joint investment with gas utilities to set up an entity that will specialize in getting natural gas supplies. It's also thinking about the joint management of facilities with other companies. Specifically, these include natural gas pipelines to supply power plants.
Another Japanese nuclear power plant is about to be shut down for regular inspections. The decision to close the plant means that 51 of Japan's 54 reactors will soon be offline. The Chugoku Electric Power Company says it will begin shutting down reactor number 2 at its Shimane power plant on Thursday evening. The work is scheduled to be completed by early Friday morning. The plant's only other reactor is already offline and is undergoing a checkup. The additional shutdown means all of the nuclear power plants run by the company will be suspended. The company is conducting stress tests on its reactors, a prerequisite for deciding whether to resume operations. But the Shimane Prefectural Government and the local municipality are insisting that the utility should first thoroughly examine last year's nuclear accident in Fukushima and seek better understanding of local residents. All 54 reactors in Japan will be offline by late April if there are no restarts before then.
The accident at Fukushima Daiichi prompted the Japanese government to implement a new inspection system for its network of nuclear plants. These so-called stress tests are meant to ensure reactors can withstand strong earthquakes and towering tsunami. The first results came back last fall. They're from the Oi facility in the Japan seacoast. Now, experts from the International Atomic Energy Agency are checking the findings. The 10-member IAEA team is trying to gauge the effectiveness of the safety procedures. It will report to Japan's nuclear watchdog, the Nuclear and Industrial Safety Agency, or NISA. The IAEA inspectors watched a safety drill on Thursday. Plant workers connected cables to an emergency generator. They based their drill on the assumption that external power was cut off. That's what actually happened last March at Fukushima Daiichi. All four of the reactors at the Oi plant are offline. The operator, Kansai Electric, carried out safety tests on two of them and submitted the results to NISA last year. The utility says the reactors could withstand a strong earthquake and a tsunami of more than 11 meters high. That's four times the projected height.
It gave us a much better view and understanding of how the utilities across Japan are going to be implementing the instructions that NISA had provided them.
More than 90% of Japan's reactors are not operating right now. They need to pass the safety checks before they can be restarted.
Japan's former leader has called for an international debate on nuclear safety in a speech at the Davos Forum. Naoto Kan was prime minister at the time of the Fukushima nuclear accident. Kan urged the world's political and business leaders on Thursday to cooperate on nuclear safety during a closed-door speech on Japan's March 11th disaster.
I stressed that we need to draw up international rules through active debates to ensure the safety of nuclear plants.
Kan said he also called for the promotion of renewable energy and energy-saving technology with the goal of achieving a nuclear-free society.